And if my friend tells me that your man is cheating on you, until I see my man cheating, he's not cheating.
Jeez. Hi guys, my name is Tobi and Verity. I'm an architect, I own my own business. I'm also a DJ and I own a fashion line.
Hi, my name is Verity Hanani. I work at a nursery as the admin manager. I love children. I like painting, it's therapeutic for me. I sing and I'm like Beyonce level at singing.
What I want in a woman? I want someone who's balanced, who's a good girl, also a bad girl.
I don't really have a type. I know people always say, oh, what's a type? But I don't really have a type, but it's more about like the connection and how we relate with each other.
Someone who is very spontaneous, because you know, I like to just come up with stuff on the spot.
It's not really about the looks for me. I mean, there are standard things that should be present, but yeah, it's more about like the relationship.
I'm a bit of a spiritual person, so someone who can match me in that light. So I think that's pretty much it.
Hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Thank you.
Right? Can I help you?
Okay, thank you.
Alright, so how you doing?
Okay, thank you. So, Anna?
Toby, it's your first time on a blind date?
100%.
How do you feel?
I don't feel weird, if that's what you're asking.
No, nervous?
No, not really. I never get nervous about anything.
That's cool. I thought she was good looking, man. Yeah, when she walked in, like, yeah, you know, cute thing, yeah.
I mean, it seemed pretty, like, calm. Like, it was calm. Yeah. I mean, no bad first impressions.
So, what do you do?
I work at a nursery. With yeah, kids, cool. 1 to 4. I'm like the admin manager, so
you like kids?
I like kids a lot. I don't have to do therapy with them, but I mean, I still always go and
disturb them. That's like my sister, you know, she works in the school as well, so you know, she really loves kids.
She like it too.
Yeah, she would, every time in church, like she's like the one carrying babies and everything. So yeah, I like kids as well, but
are you sure?
Yeah, but not that age, like, you know, like 3, 4. No, I don't like
you. You don't like 3, 4, yeah. That's when they're cute.
I mean, my godson is 3, he's a bit cute.
You have a godson.
I have a godson, yeah.
How do you have a godson? How old are you? How old do you have a godson?
I'm 27. How old are you?
Don't ask him.
Okay, yeah, so my best friend, my best friend, I introduced him to my friend, and you know, they procreated.
Oh.
And now I have a godson, so.
Yes.
What do I do? I'm an architect. I have my own business.
So what's your business? Is it like the architectural
game? Yeah, so we build all the business, we build, we design, we consult as well. And yeah, I DJ as well, you know, Saturday night, turn up. Yeah, you know. Okay, so so I have a question here. Is it a deal breaker if your partner has history with a close friend?
My partner, like, we're already together.
Yeah, your boo, your bae. Yeah.
Like, history with my close friend.
Yeah, they smashed.
Smashed. It was hilarious. I mean, I didn't expect it to say smashed, but I mean, it meant that he was comfortable talking to me, so.
Yeah.
I mean, personally, I don't have a problem with it.
If it's smashed.
I would have a problem if they're still trying to, like, but I mean, if they're done with and like it's over and then it's not
really smashed, like 200.
I think that's a cool thing, to be honest. Like, she's probably a strong-willed person, so like, you know, she can make a decision for herself. So I'm kind of calm with that, man, because you don't want situations where someone would tell your girl about something and then she goes with it instead of coming to ask you or finding out for herself or just having her general, like, you know, impression for herself. So I think that's a really, like, nice thing.
No, honestly, I have no problem with it. Like, especially if, like,
they're done, done.
Okay.
I mean, of course, like, if I found out about it eventually and, like I had a conversation with my partner.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, that's, like, done. That's not happening again. Like, I mean, I don't have a problem with it.
Okay, that's fine. I think for me, like, if... I think it just depends on how I feel about the girl. Like, if I'm fully feeling the day, like, definitely, like, you know, but if it's still early days, man, it might put me off a bit, because I mean, I know my guy has been there, especially if they smashed. So, I was thinking about the smashing thing, but especially if they smashed, like, I'll be like, ah, and that put me off a bit. But you know, she's cute, you know, she's nice, friendly, great personality, yeah, you know.
So I just was like, if fling, they have potentials, and then you found out that, oh, yeah, this is my guy smashed his girl.
So, like, okay, so we've been chatting, and then,
like, you're starting to like her. Like, it's nothing deep yet, but you know that, like, I could literally, like, see myself with this girl. And you just get that news, like, oh, like, you had, like, you get together with your guys, and he's like, oh my god, like, you know that, babe, like, I smashed her, like, I mean, we had 18, but I mean, like, we went that far. And then you're like, oh, I'm actually chatting to that girl right now. And then your guy's like, so what would you do? Just like,
I think that in that situation, I know that already, like, I'm already feeling a babe. Mm-hmm. So, like, yeah, I wouldn't care. I'd be like, guy, are you trying to piss me off or something? Like, nah, like, I think he'll,
you know, trying to take a piss. You guys can be like very
egotistic. Like, yeah.
So that's why he would like say it, and then you get pissed off, and then you just look at the girl like,
the thing about me is, I wouldn't get pissed off. Like, I would actually get pissed off at him, because I feel like he's trying to, like, mug me off here. Like, yeah, like, what are you trying to do? Are you trying to make me jealous or something? Like, you've been with her, yeah, so what? Like, do you get, like,
in some situations, yeah, definitely. Like, my ego has to come out, man. Because, well, I wouldn't even say it's ego. I say it's just being, like, very confident. Like, and, like, just being, like, aware of my self-worth.
I do not consider myself egotistic in any way.
That comes out as having an ego, then, you know, so be it.
I mean, deep down, it might pepper me a bit, but that ego in me would just be like, yo, like, dude, what are you doing? And then probably later I'll ask her about it, like, you know, like, what went on, you know, but I don't know.
So imagine, like, the guy, like, painted to you a different way from how she tells you the story.
Ah! trust issues.
Yeah, so it could literally, like, cause a lot of confliction. So it has to be that you as a person are not bothered by search, because you have your eyes on, like you have a mindset on what you want. Because, like, people could literally, like, tell you something and then it will throw you off. And then,
yeah, if definitely,
you're, like, not, like, strong-willed,
yeah, then yeah, definitely, yeah, you get thrown off. Yeah, yeah, you have a point there, actually. Yeah. To be honest, I mean, because
so, I mean, I know I'm saying that yes, I will have a problem with it, but it could come to a point where, like, maybe my friend says something really bad and then he not confirms it. I just have to have, like, second thoughts. But I mean, if I like you, I like you.
Yeah, yeah, like, and it's very hard to, like, you know, you might, I think in that moment you might be a bit upset about it, but, like, once you like someone, it's hard to just, like, throw them feelings away. So yeah, I think it's just down to, like, you liking the person. Yeah. So, yeah, that's it. Yeah, so.
The guy just keeps telling me that, yo, I don't think you should be with that girl. Like, she's so easy.
Some guys fall easily, man. Like, when I say a fine girl, your head just, you know, is gone, man. And the babe might show interest, or she might not be playing you, man. And, you know, yeah. Guys, I mean, it's happened to me before, I'm not gonna lie, so
yeah, I think a guy can be considered easy. There are lots, in fact, I don't think, I know guys are easy. There are lots of easy guys.
I mean,
just saying, because, like, there are people who listen to their friends. Personally, I don't listen to, like, okay, so if I have a relationship with someone and I want to have an issue with that person, or, like, maybe something should affect that relationship, it has to be something, like, solely between I and that person. It can't be like, oh, my friend told me that. Like, even if my friend tells me that your man is cheating on you, until I see my man cheating, he's not cheating.
Jeez.
Like, you're not cheating until I find out by myself. Like, maybe I'm working on you, or you get a text and I'm just like, oh yeah, everyone's
like, oh. So don't like third parties being involved.
Nah, I don't like third parties.
That's a good thing.
I like to, like, make decision
for yourself, based on it, so you know you're making the right decision.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, well, I mean, if my guy is telling me that, I mean, I might, because, yeah, guys tend to look out for each other, So like, am I asking like, bro, like, it's probably is it like it's and he says close friend.
Yeah.
And the thing about it is that I trust my close friends to tell me the truth. So like, if you're telling me you're like you need to free that babe, then I'm gonna ask him like, okay, why? If he has a valid point, at times they're valid points.
It can't even be valid because he had history. So like, he might not even be the same person that you're chatting like to right now. Like,
okay,
he might be a whole different person from who he had that history with.
I have some guys who I consider like my really close friend. Like, and I know, yeah, guys have friendships, but I know my close friends. I know they wouldn't lie to me. So if a guy I consider as my close friend should tell me, yo, bro, this baby's gonna mug you off. Like, trust me. Like, I know he's telling me for my own good.
Okay, so what if your friend should tell you, okay, the guy is like, he's a mug, like he's gonna mug you off, like he's mugged bare girls, like
no, that's serious
stuff. Yeah, so that's what I'm saying. Like, it depends on what the person tells you.
Well, let's just like focus on the question. It's that they had history. Okay. That like, what went wrong in their relationship.
But history is very vague. Yeah, mm-hmm. Like history can be maybe because history doesn't have to be a relationship. Let's be, you know. So what if the guy has dated one of the girls' friends, and like he did a madness, like they're like maybe he cheated. He cheated. He mugged off, and he's known to have that kind of history.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and you're chatting, and she told you like, okay, this is what's happened and everything. So that won't like influence your decision.
I'd have to see for myself.
Okay, fair enough.
I always want to see for myself. I think gets me in trouble a lot. Or like, generally, I wouldn't have a problem.
I like you said that it gets you in trouble.
But then like, I wouldn't have a problem with it. It's not a deal breaker for me.
For you?
Yeah.
Okay, so, that's fine.
It's important, but it's not something that really comes up like at the first stages of relationship. It's eventually you get to know more about the person's past, because I feel like it's not your past you're trying to talk about with this person you just met. You're just trying to sort of see where this goes. So it's more about the future when you just meet a person than the past. So it's like eventually we will talk about our past. So I mean, right now I just want to know you.
Alright, so Ella, this was very nice. You know, hope to do this, you know, some other time. Definitely.
Definitely.
Definitely. Alright. That was actually nice. I mean, she was very chatty. Felt like the conversation flowed. I wasn't really struggling for words, so that was really cool.
I think my day was pretty cool. I mean, I liked his outfit with the hat, and he looked really good. Out of 10, 8.5. I mean, he was easy to talk to, so that's like good.
It was a nice day. It was 8. I'll say 8 out of 10, to be honest. We'd like to see her again. Definitely, man. I'd like to get to know her. So, yeah.
Yes, I'd definitely like to see her again. It seems very interesting.
Are you ready to get right into it?
Super ready.